In this tutorial, we're going to be using yarn to create an interesting texture incorporated into either the background or on some of your objects that are in your still life. This could be a unique way, again, to add some texture, some color, some leading line going towards your focal point. So be creative with the yarn. I think there's a lot that you can do with it and a lot of different interesting patterns that you can come up with. So here are two examples. And again, I know they're on portraits, but think about how to take this sort of style and incorporate them onto your still lifes. But I'm going to go ahead and play the time-lapse video that I created as an example. And I'm just doing some of the basics with yarn into the background of the still life. So at the start here, I am using the yarn to just create leading line pointing towards my focal point. So I start out with glue and I'm just drawing lines with the glue where I want my yarn to go. This glue will eventually dry clear, so I'm not too worried about adding too much glue. So I'm just trying to get enough glue where this yarn is going to stay in place and not slide around too much. And then I'm just trimming the yarn and lining things up, making sure that it is connected and in the glue well enough that it will stay. And then I'm going to go ahead, and the second technique is something slightly different where you can create holes or poke holes through your piece. If you have maybe a sewing needle, this could be interesting to use thread or really thin yarn, and just kind of weave in and out and sew your yarn into your composition. But right now I'm using the yarn around the outside almost as a border. Because I do have a busy background, it might help to make my focal point stand out if I'm able to outline what I did for my still life here. So I'm using actually from your art kits the little needle or pen that's used for scratch art. And I'm starting out, there's two ways you can do this. You could either begin by poking holes around the outside and then kind of thread through the yarn if it's thin enough. So that's what I'm doing here. And then the other thing you can do is if you don't want to poke the holes ahead of time, you can just poke them as you go. So I'm just using the little end to kind of feed the yarn through, just pulling it through a little bit so that it stays. You could even add a little bit of tape on the back as you go. But at this point, I don't have the holes pre-made. I'm just kind of poking through that yarn as I go around the piece. Now, if you're struggling with this, let me know. It is a different type of technique, and this video does go very quickly. But for the most part, you're just trying to kind of poke through that yarn around the outline where you want it to go. Also, think about here where you could maybe zigzag it back and forth, or how to be creative with it beyond just doing the outside of your piece or of your still life, or even going in with some detail on the objects themselves. But again, let me know if you have any issues with the yarn, and how to incorporate that into your piece.